Hei, velkommen. Endelig NM og Junior Wine Awards for vinkelnere. Velkommen til Edderkoppen scene. Vi har flyttet oss fra Latter etter 8 år. Og vi skal begynne dagen med finalen i Junior Wine Awards. Det vil si da konkurransen for de som ikke er blitt eldre enn 25 forløpig, men som jobber i restaurant. Noen er sommelierer, andre er det ikke enda. Forhåpentligvis har de lyst alle sammen. Vi har litt praktisk info til å begynne med. Jeg skal ikke si så mye i dag. Vi har nødutganger bak dere på hver side. Toaletter, nærmeste toaletter er inn i baren eller ned i underetasjen. Så, velkommen skal dere være som sagt alle sammen. Vi har en konferansier i dag som ikke er meg, men konferansieren er da Trine Wiklemann. Ta godt imot henne. Og for de som ikke kjenner Trine, det tror jeg alle gjør nå, så er Trine da vicepresident i Norsk Vinkelnerforening. Og ja, uten Trine, ingen Vinkelnerforening, tror jeg, egentlig, rett og slett. Så tusen takk for at vi satt oppe til klokka 3 i natt. Det satt vi stor pris på.
Så, tusen takk, Liora. Alle kjenner jo selvfølgelig Liora Levi, som er president i Norsk Vinkelnerforening. Og ikke bare er hun det, men hun er jo også erfaren innen konkurranse. Hun har jo både vunnet Norgesmesterskapet tidligere, men hun er også nordisk mester. Så hun vet hva som skal foregå på scenen. God, stor applaus for Liora. Hvis dere ser at jeg klikker, så er det fordi vi har ingen klikker her, men vi har en manuell klikker, så ikke bry deg om klikkinga, den bare kommer. Så, jeg vil også gjerne si velkommen til det som for oss er årets store begivenhet, nemlig da konkurransene Junior Wine Awards, som i år arrangeres i samarbeid med Matua, og Norges mesterskapet for vinkelnere, som i år arrangeres i samarbeid med Cuvage. Vi har jo et tett pakket program. Vi skal nå hvert øyeblikk gå i gang med finalene i første konkurranse her på scenen. Så er det jo da NM litt senere ut på dagen, og vi har samtidig en vinmesse ute i salen. Men programmet kan dere alle sammen se på disse flotte heftene som alle sammen da har fått på stolryggen sin. Her står det programmet, så man kan følge med på hva som skjer når. Så skal vi prøve så godt vi kan holde oss innenfor tidsfristen. Vi skal se hva vi klarer å ta igjen i hvert fall. Men da kan vi også prate litt mens vi får deltakerne opp på scenen. Så er det jo sånn at i dagens sosiale mediesamfunn så blir det tatt mye bilder. Hvis dere skal dele på sosiale medier, blir vi veldig glad for om dere bruker hashtagene våre, som er vinkelner-NM2020 eller hashtag NVF-soms, så får vi samle alle bildene som blir tatt i løpet av dagen. Har vi alle finalistene her nå? Eller semifinalistene? Nei, da kan jeg prate litt så lenge jeg. Hvis du har en slide til. Det har vi, vet du, for i kveld så arrangeres det en middag klokken 8 her i restauranten på hotellet. Der er det fremdeles noen veldig få plasser igjen, så er man medlem av Norsk Vinkelnerforening, så kan man melde seg på den middagen. Da må man gå inn på vinkelner.no og melde seg på. Blir dere sultne før det, så, eller ikke har tid til å være med på middagen, så skal dere ikke fortvile, for klokken 17.30 her i kveld, så blir det bubbles and burgers på, rett på utsiden her. Så da er det bare å gå ut og få med seg et glass og en burger. Det blir nok innmari godt. Det er Bella Vista, en av våre partnere, som står for The Bubbles. Ja, da kan dere sitte og kose dere litt, mens vi venter på siste semifinalist. Vet du noe, Emily? Nei. Hvis dere ikke har fylt opp glassene, så kanskje noen vil løpe og gjøre det. Da vil jeg be alle fra Junior Wine Awards om å komme opp på scenen. Velkommen. Nå det sånn at konkurransene de startet jo ikke i dag, de startet i går, og disse kandidatene de har allerede vært gjennom en, både en teoriprøve og en blindsmaking, og noen praktiske elementer. Kandidatene vi har hatt i år det Isabel Zapala, som jobber på Park 29, Jens Nordnes på Vintage Kitchen, Mats Alexander Petter Henriksen, som jobber på Color Magic, Mikhail Fabrizio Alata Mamami, som jobber på Bristol Grill, Nikolai Harom Svarte fra Under og Ole Edvard Berg på Grand Café. Så, da lurer vi vel på hvem det som skal gå videre til den store finalen. Det tre stykker, og finalistene de kommer da nå i tilfeldig rekkefølge. Første finalist i Junior Wine Awards det Ole Edvard Berg. Da var vi stående. Neste finalist Nikolai Haram Svarte. Og sist, men absolutt ikke minst, Jens Nordnes. Da kan dere tre bli stående, for dere skal trekke rekkefølge. Så sier vi tusen takk til dere andre. Dere må ikke forlate området enda. Gjerne gå på messe, se på konkurransen, men vi skal ha dere opp på scenen igjen senere i dag. Da kan dere få lov til å trekke. Hvem vil begynne? Sist. Da kan dere si høyt nummeret deres.
1, 2, 3.
Kandidat nummer 1, kandidat nummer 2, kandidat nummer 3. Da kan kandidat nummer 2 og 3 gå ned igjen til kandidatrommet, og så blir kandidat nummer 1 går ned trappa der og får på seg en mikrofon. I mellomtiden så vil jeg presentere dagens dommere i Junior Wine Awards. De har vi sett ned på siden her, og der har vi Knut Espen Misje, som jobber for Osteriet, og som også trener for Norsk Vinkelnerlandslag, og en gammel ringrev i bransjen. Vi har også Dan Lista, som presenterer seg selv som en pensjonert vinkelner. Jeg vet ikke om du kanskje kan utdype den litt, Dan, hva det vil si.
Pensjonert. Jeg vil ikke karakterisere meg som pensjonert, men litt andre ting som skal gjøres. Jeg har et par løse tråder som skal nestes opp, og så skal jeg se om jeg kan få med han her på en liten roadtrip på et eller annet sted. Så vi kommer igjen med episode 2.
Spennende. Dan jo ellers tidlig både konkurrerende vinkelner, vunnet Norgesmesterskapet og har drevet norsk sommelierutdannelse i mange år, og har også vært dommer i denne konkurransen i mange år. Så en applaus til våre flinke dommere. Da har du fått på deg mikrofon, så da vi klare for kandidat nummer 1. Velkommen til finalen, kandidat nummer 1.
Takk.
Dette restauranten din i kveld, og du vil få ulike oppgaver. Du begynner her, så du kan komme hit. Det står tre viner foran deg. Vi vil vite druesort, hvilket land og region hver kommer fra, hva som fellesnevneren for disse tre vinene. Du har 3 minutter. Oppgaven forstått, eller skal jeg gjenta?
Kan jeg gjenta?
Det kan jeg. Det står tre viner foran deg. Vi vil vite druesort, hvilket land og region hver kommer fra, hva som fellesnevneren for disse tre vinene. Og du har 3 minutter.
Ja, takk. Vin nummer en er en Sauvignon Blanc fra Marlborough, New Zealand. Kommer tilbake til vin nummer to. Vin nummer tre. Også Sauvignon Blanc. Denne kommer fra Loiredalen i Frankrike. Vin nummer to vil jeg også sagt er Sauvignon Blanc, men fra Steiermark i Østerrike. Så fellesnevneren for disse tre vinene er at de er alle laget på samme drue. Takk.
Du har to gjester her. Dekanter og server en flaske rødvin til disse to gjestene. Du har to, nei, unnskyld, du har seks minutter.
Ja, takk.
Dekanter og server en flaske rødvin til disse to gjestene. Du har seks minutter.
Ja, takk. Ja, hva kan jeg hjelpe dere med?
En flaske rødvin som vi har bestilt.
Selvfølgelig. Så, da er det Penfold sin Cabernet Shiraz blend fra bind 389, 2017 gang, kommer fra Australia. Korken var i utmerket tilstand. Ingen tegn til oksidering eller feil. Vinen smakte også meget eksemplarisk. Ønsker du å inspisere korken selv? Ønsker du at karaffelen eller flasken står på bordet?
Nei, jeg tror bare den står bak.
Selvfølgelig. Er det da noe annet jeg kan hjelpe dere med for kvelden?
Vi ønsker at du setter drikke til denne menyen. Gi en kort begrunnelse for valgene. Til osten ønsker vi alkoholfri drikke. Du har 5 minutter.
Kan du gjenta oppgaven?
Det kan jeg. Vi ønsker at du setter drikke til denne menyen. Gi en kort begrunnelse for valgene. Til osten ønsker vi alkoholfri drikke. Du har 5 minutter.
Yes, til grillet sjøkreps fra Nisund med estragonsmør. Så vil jeg egentlig ta til litt klassisk valg. Det er jo selvfølgelig skalldyr, og hva vel mer klassisk enn godt glass champagne? Så jeg ville gått for standard brutter og sau fra Charles Heidschik. Den har fint tåset preg på seg, en god syre for å hjelpe litt med estragonsmøret, men samtidig så vil jo tåsinessen i vinen gå bra til den naturlige sødmen i kamskjellet. Sjøkrepsen, beklager. Til neste retten, en bressert oksesjake med sellerirospuré. Så trenger du ikke noe rødvin med alt for mye tanniner. Det er jo bressert, så det kommer til å være ganske mørkt i stilen sin. Så jeg vil faktisk godt for en Carignan fra Languedoc-Roussillon, fra Domaine Infant, 2017 årgang. Har mer juiciness som hjelper litt på å komplementere selve oksesjaken som er bressert, og du har ikke for mye tanniner som kommer til å overkjøre kjøttet. Munkebier med karamelliserte nøtter. Dere ønsket alkoholfritt alternativ til dette, så da foreslår jeg egentlig at vi bare kjører på med litt mer sparkling. Gjerne da, eller da vil jeg egentlig anbefalt litt himmeleple fra Sverige. Det er en fin sødme på det som kommer til å gå veldig bra sammen med selve osten. Du har også de boblene som hjelper litt mer på fettet. Multekrem på nyr. En dessertvin, selvfølgelig, som har litt sødme på seg til multene. Og gjerne også litt syre for å ta nyren, som kan bli litt sånn tjukkere eller fetere i konsistensen. Så en god Riesling spetløse ville passet bra til dette. Gjerne da også fra Moseldalen i Tyskland, så du får litt mer av de gule fruktene, eller grønne fruktene. Virker det som gode alternativer? Så flott. Er det noe mer jeg kan gjøre for dere i kveld?
Ja, da var du igjennom. Hvordan føles det?
Ja, ikke sånn som så. Ja.
Er det din første konkurranse?
Første gang i finalen i hvert fall.
Første gang i finalen. Gratulerer. En ekstra stor applaus. Takk, kan du... Unnskyld. Hei.
Ja. Skal ikke gå enda, nei.
Nei. Da går du opp og får tatt av deg mikrofonen, og så kan du få lov til å komme og sette deg i salen og følge med på resten.
Selvfølgelig. Takk.
Stor applaus, dere! Da blir det en kort pause på noen veldig få minutter mens vi rigger om scenen, så da er det tid for å gå på toalettet eller hente seg noe mer vin. Men vær tilbake om bare noen veldig få minutter, så kommer vi med kandidat nummer 2. Velkommen tilbake. Vi ønsker kandidat nummer 2. Velkommen opp på scenen. Velkommen, kandidat 2.
Takk.
Dette er restauranten din i kveld, og du vil få ulike oppgaver. Du begynner her. Hvert øyeblikk her. Det står 3 viner foran deg. Vi vil vite druesort og hvilke land og region hver kommer ifra. Hva er fellesnevneren for disse 3 vinene? Du har 3 minutter. Skal jeg gjenta?
Ja, takk.
Det står 3 viner foran deg. Vi vil vite druesort og hvilke land og region hver kommer fra. Og hva er fellesnevneren for disse tre vinene? Du har 3 minutter.
Skal jeg sette i gang?
Ja.
Yes, takk. Vin nummer 1. Vin nummer 1 er en ung Riesling fra Østerrike, produsert i en klassisk Riesling-stil fra Kampdal. Vinifisert på ståltank. Årgang 2018. Vin nummer 2 er en Grüne Veltliner fra Steiermark, Østerrike, vinifisert på fat, delvis gamle østerrikske eikefat, årgang 2017. Vin nummer 3 er også en Grüne Veltliner fra Neusiedlersee, østlig delen av Østerrike. Vinifisert på ståltank, årgang 2016. Fellesnevneren for disse er at alle er fra Østerrike.
Dekanter og server en flaske rødvin til disse to gjestene. Du har 6 minutter. Skal jeg gjenta?
Ja, takk.
Dekanter og server en flaske rødvin til disse to gjestene. Du har 6 minutter. Du kan starte.
Hei, velkommen. Da skal jeg hente rødvin til dere. Så bind 389 fra Penfolds, sørlig del av Australia, på Cabernet og Shiraz, årgang Så har jeg valgt Shiraz Cabernet glass til dere. Sånn, det er en ganske fyldig, krydret og intens vin. korken er i toppstand. Håper det er ok at jeg kvalitetssjekker vinen for dere. Ingen feil på nesen, den viser seg veldig bra. Rense karaffelen for eventuelle rester av støv eller såpe eller noe annet fra rengjøring. Ah, nydelig. Absolutt ingen feil på vinen her. Nydelig fyldig stil av Cabernet Shiraz fra South Australia. 2017, så den er ung, trenger litt luft. Mulig også at det er noe bunnfall, ettersom det er en ganske ekstrahert kraftig stil. Sammen med denne vinen så vil dere få servert grillet entrecôte. Den kommer med broccolini på siden, salat eller tilbehør basert på asparges og tomat, og en bearnaisesaus. Kan ikke se noe tydelig bunnfall i vinen her. Ja, litt. Jeg avslutter dekanteringen. Korken til din inspeksjon eller samling. Hvis du bare vil kvalitetssjekke vinen. Perfekt. Det her er jo akkurat hva man har lyst til å drikke ved siden av litt grillet kjøtt, ettersom at flere av litt sånn mørke grillede notene gjenspeiler seg både i retten og i vinen. Ønsker du å beholde korken på bordet? Ønsker du flasken eller karaffelen stående på bordet?
Nei.
Perfekt. Tusen takk. Da får du bare nyte vinen. Maten er på vei. Yes, takk for meg.
Vi ønsker at du setter drikke til denne menyen. Gi en kort begrunnelse for valgene. Til osten ønsker vi alkoholfri drikke. Du har 5 minutter.
Jeg har et spørsmål. Ønsker du spesifisert produsent årgang?
Nei.
Vil du gjenta oppgaven?
Vi ønsker at du setter drikke til denne menyen. Gi en kort begrunnelse for valgene. Til osten ønsker vi alkoholfri drikke. Du har 5 minutter.
Takk. Grillet sjøkreps misun med estragonsmør. Der kjører vi jo en wine pairing og en aperitif i ett, så her går vi med en champagne, en 100% Pinot Noir, som gir litt mer fylle og litt mer rikhet, sånn at den også klarer den fete og litt kraftigere smøret. Så vi går for en Valérie Frisson, Côte d'Or, 100% Pinot Noir, Gustave Cuvée. Det er en non-vintage. Brassert oksekjake med sellerirotpuré. Her har du en ganske fyldig rett og rik rett, så her trenger vi en litt rikere rødvin. Her vil jeg anbefale en Cabernet Shiraz Blend 389 fra Penfolds, South Australia, 2017-årgang. Og til dessert så er det Munkeby med karamelliserte nøtter. Og her vil jeg gå for en klassisk Tokaj i en litt friskere stil, sånn at du klarer å få, eller at vi lager litt kontrast med desserten deres, så det ikke blir for flatt, og det blir litt mer spennende, litt mer kontraster. Så vi går for en Late Harvest Tokaj 2015 fra Hetsolo. Og multekrem på ny, da har dere fått litt et vin i glasset, så er det deilig å avslutte med en alkoholfritt. Da anbefaler jeg å gå for en eplemost fra Ringi på Gravensteinepler. Yes, takk.
Så bra. Da du ferdig. Tusen takk.
Ja, deilig. Takk.
Da kan du gå opp og få deg mikrofonen der oppe og bare sette deg i salen.
Herlig.
Mens vi da rigger om scenen og gjør klar til kandidat nummer tre, så er det sånn at det er Matcha som er sponsor for Junior Wine Awards i år. Og vi er så heldige at vi har eier og driver av Matcha her i dag, Bill Spence. Vi vil gjerne få han opp på scenen sånn at han kan fortelle oss litt om Matcha. Så welcome up on stage, Bill Spence. Welcome.
Thank you.
Can I have a mic here? So it's so nice to have you here.
Thank you very much. It's nice to be here. It's I come to Norway every year, and I enjoy it more and more every time. And it's great that we're sponsoring the wine education of sommeliers, and we try and do this around the world if we can, just to express the wine side of it. Being the first to grow Sauvignon Blanc in New Zealand, we like to be the first to try and educate more and more people towards wine. A great looking place, isn't it, eh? My home. But thank you very much, and good luck to all the contestants. I've been watching it. It's a great way to get people to know about wine.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's an honor to have you here. Da det fremdeles litt tid til vi klare for kandidat nummer tre, så hvis noen ønsker å løpe på beina eller hente litt vin, så har man et par tre minutter på det. Velkommen tilbake. Vi er klare for kandidat nummer tre. Velkommen på scenen.
Takk.
Dette er restauranten din i kveld, og du vil få ulike oppgaver. Du begynner her. Litt øyeblikk. Her, vet du. Det står tre viner foran deg. Vi vil vite druesort og hvilket land og region hver kommer fra. Hva er fellesnevneren for disse tre vinene? Du har tre minutter.
Takk.
Vil du at jeg skal hente?
Ja, takk.
Det står tre viner foran deg. Vi vil vite druesort og hvilket land og region hver kommer fra. Hva er fellesnevneren for disse tre vinene? Du har tre minutter.
Takk.
Vær så god.
Vin 1, en Riesling fra Rheinhessen i Tyskland. Vin 2, en Riesling fra Alsace i Frankrike. Og vin 3 en Riesling fra Mosel i Tyskland. Så alle vinerne Riesling er fellesnevnet. Takk.
Du har to gjester her. Dekanter og server en flaske rødvin til disse to gjestene. Du har 6 minutter.
Takk.
Skal jeg gjenta?
Ja, takk.
Dekanter og server en flaske rødvin til disse to gjestene. Du har 6 minutter.
Takk.
Vær så god.
Så da har vi Penfolds BIN 389, Cabernet Shiraz 2017. Korken er fin sånn. Vil jeg bare sjekke om vinen er i god stand. Lukter helt som den skal. Så vil jeg bare skylle karaffen for eventuelt sediment og såprester og partikler, den slags. Skal jeg bekrefte at vinen er i orden. Og den akkurat som den skal være. Dette er jo en relativt ung vin, så jeg ville ikke forvente at det skulle være så mye bunnfall, men det kan alltid være greit å sjekke for sikkerhets skyld. Det var heller ingen bunnfall å snakke om, så da skjenker jeg alltid karaffelen. Er det noen som vil smake på vinen? Der har du korken til inspeksjon. Den gjør den. Det står det. Så til den vinen her så vil jeg anbefale ytre filet av reinsdyr. Som skal svære med litt sånn, hva jeg skal kalle det. Animalsk og litt djupere smaker. Vi har en jordskokkpuré gjort med hasselnøtte, samt en portvinsaus gjort med litt tyttebær, og så har vi også litt fritert mose til slutt her. Skal dere beholde korka?
Vi er ferdig. Tiden er over.
Hei. Vi ønsker at du setter drikke til denne menyen. Gi en kort begrunnelse for valgene. Til osten ønsker vi alkoholfri drikke. Du har 5 minutter.
Så til første rett, grillet sjøkreps fra Misund med estragonsmør. Så har vi en grüner Veltliner fra Martin Muttenthaler i Wachau i Østerrike. Så vi har Spitzergraben, litt kjøligere område i Wachau, og her er det Vergelkots 2017 vi skal gå for. Videre til brasert oksekjake med sellerirotpuré skal vi til USA. Min som heter Monkey Jacket fra Michael Cruz, temmelig fersk produsent der. En blend av en rekke ulike druesorter, Valgi, Syrah, Sinso, Carignan og et par andre. Og i en brukbar juicy stil, men fortsatt med litt tannin og et litt sånn lett animalsk pepperaktig preg her, som vil gå ja, fint sammen med både en litt sødmen i sellerirotpuréen og for så vidt sødmen i en brasert oksekjake som man har der også. Videre et alkoholfritt alternativ til Munkeby. En kitthost med karamelliserte nøtter. Da vi lager mandelmelk, som vi har blandet med Filippa-eplemost der. Og den mandelmelken er også gjort med både mandel og hasselnøtte, så man får et, litt av det samme nøtteaktige preget som går igjen i garnityret til osten her. Så skal vi videre på dessert, multikrem på nyr. Der har vi en Jurançon fra Brubaché, La Quintessence på druen Grommenseng, 2012-årgang der også. Så det er en vin med et litt sånn gult aromabilde, kan man si. Har nok sødme til å håndtere multe, men multe er også litt syrlig, kan også være lett bitter, så vil også ha en litt syrlig snert på vinen igjen. Gjennom måltid vil jeg svært vann fra Voss, og det ser dere allerede i gang med her. Kaffe fra Tim Vennelbo, Caballero Geisha. Så det er en familie som heter Caballero, holdt til på Honduras, og lager utrolig delikate og komplekse kaffe, og særlig geishaen er utrolig raffinert. En av vekk kunne for eksempel vært en Marsala fra Marco de Bortoli med 10 år. Fin utvikling, litt sødme og litt sånn lett oksidativt preg der til slutt. Takk.
Ja, da er du ferdig. Hvordan føles det?
Greit å være ferdig, altså. Ja.
Da venter det vin oppe i salen, så er det bare å gå ut og så slappe av.
Takk.
Nå blir det en pause, for nå skal vi rigge om til Norsk Vinkellnermesterskap, som begynner her om en drøy kvarter, håper vi. Men vi signaliserer ute i messeområdet når det er klart for å komme inn i salen igjen. Så er det bare å ta med seg glassene og gå ut på vinmesse og kose seg, og så starter vi snart opp igjen med Norsk Vinkellnermesterskap. Velkommen tilbake inn i salen. Det neste som skal foregå på scenen nå kommer til å foregå på engelsk. Og det er både fordi at vi har noen gjestedeltagere med oss fra utlandet, men også fordi at Norsk Vinkellermesterskap alltid foregår på engelsk. Just a friendly reminder to all of you. On all pictures you post on social media today, please use our hashtags on everything. This year's competition, the Norwegian sommelier, I'm sorry, now it's gone too much for me as well. The Norwegian Championship for Sommeliers 2020 is sponsored by Cuvage. And if you haven't done it yet, in the next break, you should go to them out there in the fair hall there and try their blind tasting. It's very funny, and after candidate number 3 today, we will announce the winner of the blind tasting, and that will be one of you guys. So all of you should try the blind tasting at Cuvage in one of the breaks. So, and also again, I said it before today, if you are getting hungry, don't despair, at 5:30 today, there will be bubbles and burgers out here. So everyone will get a glass of bubbles from Bella Vista and a really nice burger. So just look forward to that one. So, the competition. This year we had 14 contestants in the competition. And I would like to ask all of you to please come up on the stage. So, the candidates this year is Alexander Iversen, Uma Kasse, Alexandra Åberg, Løve Restaurant og Bar, Allan Andreasen, Advitsia, Andreas Høgfeldt, Bratteri West. Christian Engfer, Norda, Oslo. Emil Reinton fra Vinoteket. Francesco Marsola, Park Hotel Vossevangen. Henrik Dahl Jansen, Speilsalen Britannia Hotel. And we had 2 guest competitors, Kamil Wojtasiak from Poland. Maximilian Wilm from Germany. Petter Svanes, Lamarck. Reidar Johansen, Park Hotel Vossevangen. Robert Johansen, Park Hotel Vossevangen. And last but not least, Sander Jonsson Tango. So, but out of these 14 candidates, 8 of them went on to the semifinals. And the semifinalists were, and when I say your name, I would like you to take one small step front, not too many steps, but one small one. And the semifinalist this year is Petter Svanes, Andreas Høgfeldt, Francesco Marsola, Robert Johansen, Henrik Dahl Jansen, Alexander Iversen, and Maximilian Wilm and Kamal Wojtasiak. Give them all a big hand. So then I would like to ask the rest of you to please leave the stage and sit down and enjoy the show. Because now we are going to announce who the four finalists are. And there are four finalists in this final because we have two guest competitors, and one of them is going on to the finals. So, are you anxious? Do you want to know who it is? In no particular order, here are our four finalists. The first one, Alexander Iversen. And the second finalist is Henrik Dahl Jansen. Our third finalist is Francesco Marzola. And then from our two guest competitors, we have Maximilian Wilm. So, congratulations, everyone. The other ones of you, thank you so much. You can just now relax and sit down and enjoy the rest of the day. But do not go far, because we want all of you up on stage later today. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now I would like to ask you all to pick a number from this bowl. That will be your number on stage, your candidate number. You can start. And say your name, the number out loud to the judges.
Number three.
Number four. Oh. What's my candidate number?
So, two.
Number one.
Okay. Then I would like to ask number two, three, and four to go down to the candidate room. And candidate number one, you can go up to our technician up there, and he will give you a mic. So I will see you all later. Thank you. So while we are waiting for our first finalists, I would like to introduce our honorable jury for today. We have in our jury Merete Bø. She's a head judge of this jury. She is downstairs preparing everything. We also have Per Holm, the president of Germany, sitting here. We also have Piotr Kamecki, president from Poland. We have Heidi Hansen from Kulinarisk Akademi. And we have Robert Lee, who is former European champion. Is our contestant ready? Almost? Then you can come up on the stage.
Didn't expect that.
Welcome, candidate number one. This is your restaurant for the evening. You have 21 minutes to fulfill the tasks given to you by these guests. You will start here and then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task.
Okay.
Do you want me to repeat?
Yes, please.
This is your restaurant for the evening. You have 21 minutes to fulfill the tasks given to you by these guests. You will start here and then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task. You may start.
Perfect.
We have already enjoyed our aperitif and are now ready to start our four-course meal. Here's the menu. We have only ordered the wine for the main course, a half bottle of Chateau Moussard 2001, which we would like you to decant for us. Please recommend wines to the remaining three dishes.
Okay, perfect. We have a beautiful menu. We start with some fresh fin de clair oysters. I would recommend with that 2014 Blanc de Blanc sparkling wine from Graham Beck. It's a Cape Classique coming from the Robertson area in the north of South Africa. So in the north of the Western Cape, not in the north of South Africa. But this is one of the first wineries in South Africa who concentrated on producing just sparkling wines, and very elegant, have a very nice nutty flavor, which goes very well with the salty taste of the fresh oysters. Then we have a consommé de Morel, so we have a classic soup with some mushroom flavors. I would recommend with that sherry. I would recommend you Amontillado sherry from Gonzalez Bias, the Cuatro Palmas, which is aged for more than 50 years in the barrels, and so the yeast broke down, so it's got beautiful nutty flavors, but you have this lightly oxidation taste, which goes very well with the mushroom soup. You already choose the Chateau Moussa. I'll be back right now, or after my last recommendation with that. And we have the Crêpe Saucette in the last course. With that, I would recommend you a 2008 Bucuram. This is a Pasito de Pantelleria from the insul of Pantelleria down on Italy. So it's more in the south than Sicilia, but it belongs to Italy. It's on the high of Tunisia. And Marco de Bartoli is a very famous producer for Marsala as well. And he produced this specialty from Sibibo grapes, which is another word for Muscati Alexandris. And this is have this beautiful dried orange flavors, which are also typical for the Crêpe Saucette, and but also brings a fresh acidity. The vintage is 2008 of this wine. And then I will do now the red wine for you. Do it here, then everyone can follow me. So just to make sure you ordered the bottle?
Yes.
Yes. Want to take a look first is the 2001. We have a demi bottle of the Chateau Moussa from the Bekaa Valley in the Lebanon. I'm sorry that we don't have a big bottle left for four, but this is a very rare wine, and we have to take the small one, but it's worth of it. Yesterday for dinner we decided to have a 2003. I would prefer 2001 more. And 2001, quite cool vintage also in the Lebanon, but it's a beautiful matured wine. The wine need always a lot of time to develop and should be not drunk too young. I'm a big fan of this wine. It's the grapes are French based, but not a Cabernet blend or something. We have Carignan and Cinsault are the main grapes for this wine. And they are growing in the Lebanon, the Bekaa Valley, since more than 100 years. And the family of Rochard is really the well-known winery we have in this region. And the special thing here is that the winery and the vineyards are around about 80 kilometers far away from each other. That's they have to transport it every time. That it's also a typical thing which happens very often with Chateau Musard. The cork breaks. Could happen.
Can you tell us about Canard à la Presse, our main course?
Canard à la Presse, it's a beautiful main course from the classic French cuisine. It's canard, it's cooked in a hole, and then it's, so the stays at once, the canard, and the breast is a special area in France, which is famous for their growing of birds, especially chicken and ducks and so on. And I will just try it if it's okay. Amazing. This is this nice acidity, which is typical for a Chateau Musard. The Canard de la Bresse is, give me just a second, I will concentrate on the depot, because always the wines have always a lot of depot from Chateau Musard, but it's okay. Here it comes. So the cork for you, sir. Just to check the menu for a second. Yeah, I did a mistake. I talked about the breast region. I hope the duck is coming from this region because it's the best region. But Canard à la Bresse is a traditional dish where the duck is cooked quite bloody. It's cooked very short, and then we drench it here at your table, and we cook a sauce out of the blood and the liver of the canard, and that's really something special. It's a very traditional dish. I saw it once in my life, but it's really something special. You reduce the sauce with the blood, and then you give also some cognac into it to bring the flavors out of it. So do you want to keep the bottle on the table, or should I put it away? I take it to the station. So. Should I keep the cork, or do you like to keep the cork, or should I put it? I put it away. Perfect. See, you already have some water. Is there anything else I can do for you? No? Okay. Then enjoy your wine and your menu, and enjoy the evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
We have been studying your wine list, but there seems to be a few errors. Could you please correct it for us?
Sure. So the 19 Mont Blanc de Blanc is not from Sussex. It's Kent, I think. Marlborough is in New Zealand, not in Australia. The Paul Rosé Sir Winston Churchill in 1975 was not produced. It was not yet produced. I think they started in 1978 with it. The Prager Kellerberg Grüne Veltliner is not in the Kremstal, it's in the Wachau area in Austria. Chakra is not a combination with Chaumac Rouleau, I think. it's not a combination. Patagonia, Argentina, that's right. Alvaro Palacios Lermita was 1992, also too early, I think. It was produced the first time in 93, when I'm right. So the Domaine Romière, Chambon, Messigny. Come back later on it. Chateau Montalina is not in Sonoma Coast, it's in Napa Valley, California, USA. De Lauré is not the Blanc of Chapoutier, I think. It's a red, or I'm not sure of the claw of the white one. The Morillon from Muster is not a Große Steirische Klassiklage, it's an Austrian table wine. For Montepulciano di Abruzzo, there's missing the DOCG from Emidio paper in the wine list. Amazing wine. Maybe in Saint Prix we should add that it's a Sauvignon Blanc and not a Chardonnay. Maybe it's to, if you want to give a grape. And Maximin Grünhaus Abtsberg Riesling Bern Auslese is from the Mosel Valley. Not from the Ruwer, to be right. Chateau de Chem is not in the Bazac, it's in the classic Sauternes area. No, sorry, it's in the Bazac. It's not Imperial Chateau de Chem, it's called as Premier Cru Grand Cru Classé Supérieur. That's not Imperial, is the wrong word for it. And Essentia. Asu Essentia are not produced anymore, I think. But yeah, this is what I want to say to the wine list. Thank you.
Excuse me.
Yes.
We would like to have some after dinner drinks.
Sounds great.
Can I have a coffee and an avec? And my friend would like something more refreshing.
Yes, can you repeat it, please?
Yes, we would like some after-dinner drinks. I would like a coffee and an avec, and my friend wants something a bit more refreshing.
Okay, perfect. Do you have any preferences in the coffee or just what I have? I have an espresso, Peru organic. Ah, okay. So the machine have to heat a little bit. Do that. So, a little bit. I start with you, sir, if it's okay. We need something more refreshing. I tried yesterday a beautiful drink with some Tio Pepe, some Chinmara. So you have this spiciness, this herbaceousness of the Chinmara with rosemary and thyme. The Tio Pepe bring also some saltiness inside, and I pour it up with the Mediterranean tonic from Fever Tree, which supports these flavors quite good, if you like. Sounds great. Then I start with that and let the coffee run. So. Chinmara, I also add a little dash of lemon juice to give it a little bit more freshness. Took around about 2 cl from everything. It's the right combination. And now take our, yeah, that's the Mediterranean one. It up with it, so then we garnish it with some estragon. Here we go, sir. Hope you will enjoy it. And so for you, the coffee. I don't know. I don't have any on the plate. I hope it's okay. I give it in this way to you. Cannot also offer you any sugar. I have a sugar liqueur if you, or sugar, okay, perfect. And to be honest, the last drink you ordered, I didn't know it well, so I have a dark rum. Maybe I can offer you this one as a digestif, because to be honest, I'm not strong into the cocktails, so I have a rum coming from Venezuela. And maybe I think coffee and rum is also a good combination. Yeah, we take this glass as well. I'll give you a little bit more. Maybe it works as well. Sorry for that. And I will ask my barkeeper when he's right back from his break what's in this drink already. And then we get it to you. Anything else I can do for you? Fine? Perfect.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Then you can go down and relax a bit and
sounds
watch
great.
The rest of them.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Then we will have a short break while we change the stage, so you can all stretch your legs and get some more wine in your glasses, and be back in just a few minutes. Welcome back. Before our second finalist, I have got Liora Levi, the president of the Norwegian Sommelier Association, here on stage with me. And we will just have a little information in Norwegian, so sorry to our foreign friends. It will be quick. Så, men, Liora, det er jo noen som har bursdag i år. Det er jubileum.
Ja. Vinkelleforeningen har bursdag.
Klart.
Det har vi for så vidt hvert år, da. Men i år er det litt spesielt, for vi fyller 30 år. Så det kan jo ikke være 30-årsjubileum uten ordentlig jubileumsfest.
Kan ikke det?
Nei.
Når skal vi feste? Alle søndag, må sette deg i boka nå med en gang.
Søndag 11. oktober. Så det er bare å ta frem telefonen. Jeg ser ingen telefoner. Søndag 11. oktober er det storstilt fest på Bristol. Thon Hotel er jo en partner av Norsk Vinkellerforening, og vi har booket festsalen der, så det blir kjempegøy.
Ja, det blir et arrangement som kommer til å vare hele dagen, med vinmesse først og ulike kåringer. Blant annet Norges beste vinkart, som nå skal kåres for tredje året på rad i samarbeid med Kapital Vin og Hegnar Media. Tidligere så har vi den kåringen vært på våren, men nå flytter vi da den til oktober, så det er enda en grunn til å komme på bursdagsfest. Det er at også blir kåring av Norges beste vinkart. Det vil man ikke gå glipp av.
Nei, og da er det jo selvfølgelig også veldig viktig at de som ikke har begynt å tenke på å sende inn vinkart til kåringen enda, kan jo begynne å tenke på det så vidt. Det er flere og flere som deltar i kåringen hvert år nå, og den kommer til å bli både større og bedre, og mer spennende ettersom både året som kommer går og fremover.
Så da håper vi ser alle medlemmer av Norsk Vinkellerforening på den store bursdagsfesten 11. oktober på Bristol.
Takk. Vi ses der, og så er det tid for neste kandidat, er det ikke det?
Det er det. Kandidat number 2. Please come up on stage.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Welcome, candidate number 2.
Thank you very much.
This is your restaurant for the evening.
Excellent.
You have 21 minutes to fulfill the tasks given to you by these guests. You will start here and then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task. Do you want me to repeat?
No, that's clear.
Okay.
Could you just repeat the time, please?
21 minutes. Starting now.
Excellent. Super. So, good evening. How may I help you?
Hello. We have already enjoyed our aperitif and are now ready to start our four-course meal.
Super.
We have only ordered the wine for the main course, a half bottle of Chateau Musard 2001, which we would like you to decant for us. Please recommend wines for the remaining three dishes.
Excellent, sir. Super. So I will get right to it. I will just have a little look in our cellar and see which amazing wines we can choose for your dinner today. So give me a few moments, please. So just checked to reconfirm the bottle, the 2001 half bottle of Musard, and it appears to be in very good condition with very good top neck filling, so it should be just super for you. And for the other wines, for the Fin de Clair, of course, one of the most elegant types of oyster, and also a personal favorite of mine, I must add, we just serve it lightly gratinated with some Parmesan Sabayon, based with champagne, of course. The wine for this would be a Grüne Veltline from Austria, from the Käferberg vineyard in Kamptal, Weingut Bundelmeier, one of the signature producers of Austria. And his vintage 2017, so the young, fresh vintage. Beautiful minerality, beautiful citrus character to pair with the oysters and also to cut through the hollandaise. For the consommé de morel, it's again quite classic dish. We have the morel mushrooms, which is super, super flavorsome and very highly regarded, almost on the same level as truffle, I might say. We will add some of those for you as well, sir. But it's a consommé, so with chicken stock, and we have the morel mushrooms, a little bit of morel raviolis as well inside, and super good Chardonnay with this from Napa Valley, from Gergich Estate in Carneros, in Napa. The 15 vintage, so it's seen a little bit of development, but Gergich always makes wine that's also quite fresh because it doesn't do any malolactic fermentation. It's also biodynamic and certified, so really an exciting enterprise in the US. For your Canard à la Presse, you have already made the best choice possible, I guess, so I'm looking forward to serve you that. And with the Crêpes Suzette, we will finish off classically with Sauternes, the 2001 vintage of Chateau Giraud from Sauternes. It's an organic Sauternes estate, which is really coming around quite beautifully now. Of course, 01 was an amazing year in Sauternes, and they use both Semillot and Sauvignon Blanc in their grape in their wine. So it's really an excellent choice with the Crêpes Suzette to refreshen you after all these beautiful courses and, of course, beautiful wines. Does that sound satisfying, sir? Excellent. Would you like to keep the menu? Yeah. Excellent for your diary. Perfect. Madam? So, sir, the 01 Musard. Did you enjoy your aperitif, all well? Excellent. So as you already pre-ordered this bottle, we've left it upstanding since yesterday, so there should be a fine concentration of sediments at the base. But of course, we'll just reconfirm with a little bit of careful decantation. There's a little bit of seepage on the cork, but hopefully it hasn't affected wine too much. Okay. So the cork seems to be in very good condition, but we have a small situation as the rest of the cork has broken off, sir. Would you like me to continue? Okay, so. And the wine is also in good condition, so hopefully the cork situation won't be too much of a problem for us. Fantastic. I'm just going very carefully now to avoid any cork coming through.
So, I have a question.
Yes, sir.
What can you tell us about Canard à la Presse, our main course?
Well, it's one of our signatures of the house. It's a super traditional French way of really maximizing the flavor in not just the canard, the duck, but you can also do it, of course, with any kind of poultry or even with shellfish. In fact, there was just an article quite recently about it in terms of getting all the flavors out of crustaceans. So it's a super nice technique for that as well. And there's the cork for you. So it's basically a quite big silver press, normally quite heavy, that applies pressure to the carcass of the animal, so you can get all the meat juices, but also some of the blood, which super, which also helps to even out the sauce and make it even richer. And of course, maximizing the flavor. Would you like some more information about the press, or was that sufficient? One of the signature restaurants, of course, for the press, in addition to ourselves, is in Paris, Le Tour d'Argent. They also have a fantastic wine list that you might enjoy as your wine connoisseur, sir. Would you like to keep the cork for your collection?
No.
Excellent, thank you. I've left the bottle here and a beautiful small decanter from Riedel as well, so you can have it under control, and hope you enjoy your dinner. Is there anything else for you, sir? Excellent. Well, enjoy.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir. How may I, what can I do for you?
Yes, there's, we have been studying your wine list, but there seems to be a few errors.
Oh, really?
Could you please correct the wine list for us?
I will do my very best, sir, of course. And apologize as well in advance. Of course, we shouldn't have any mistakes. So let's have a look. So for sparkling wines, we have the Night Timber Blanc de Blanc 2012 from Sussex, England. Then we have the Arras Grand Vintage 07, Marlborough, Australia. Well, Marlborough is not in Australia, it's in New Zealand, one of the signature regions, really. And make very exciting sparkling wines on the Sauvignon Blanc grapes, of course, as well as producing some Chardonnay and Rieslings and other exciting grapes. The Paul Rocher, Sir Winston Churchill 75 from Champagne, France. Also correct. For the white wines, we have from Prager, the Kellerberg Grüneveltliner Smaragd 13 from Kremstal, Austria. Prager is not a producer in Kremstal, he's a producer in the Wachau area, and again, one of the signature producers of the country. We have the Chakra Jean-Marc Rouleau Chardonnay, from Patagonia and Argentina, 18 vintage. Which appears to be correct. Very fresh vintages, of course, from the New World, as they are a little bit ahead of us here in the Northern Hemisphere. For the red wines, from Roumier, the Chambon Musigny Premier Cru Clos Labussière, 10, from Burgundy, France. Appears to be correct. We have Delvaro Palacio L'Ermita, 1992, from Priorat in Spain, which should be correct as well for you, sir. And then for our larger formats, we have from Chapoutier, Loré Hermitage Magnum, the White Hermitage, 14 Ron, fine. And also from Chateau Montelena, the Cabernet Sauvignon Magnum, 1994, from Sonoma Coast in the USA. Well, Chateau Montelena is not in Sonoma Coast, it's in Napa Valley. So that's obviously a mistake there, very sorry, sir. For the natural wines, we have from Domaine Alice and Oliver, the Moor, Saint-Prix, 15, from Burgundy, France. And then we also have the Weingut Maria und Sepp Muster, Gräfin Moriot, Gross STK Lage, from Südsteiermark in Austria. Which appears to be correct, although I believe we shouldn't really write the Gross in the wine in addition to the STK. And of course, Moriot is the Austrian name for Chardonnay, if you weren't aware, sir. And the Amidio Pepe Montepulciano d'Abruzzo 01 is also good. And for our sweet wines, we have from Maximim Grunhaus, his Riesling Bernhauslese, 18 from Rheinhessen. This wine is not released, sir, unfortunately. We're a little bit ahead of ourselves. And for, of course, not to try and fool you, of course, but yeah. For the Chateau de Chem, Imperial, 84 from Barsac, Bordeaux, France. De Chem is not in the commune of Barsac, it's in the commune of Sauternes itself. And Royal Tokaji Asu Essentia 11 from Tokaj Hegyalja in Hungary would also appear to be correct, sir. Would you like to hang on to this?
Yes, please.
Yes. Is there anything else I can do for you?
Thank you.
Excellent.
Excuse me.
Of course, sir. Hi.
Hi.
Sorry.
We would like to have some after-dinner drinks.
So certainly, yeah.
Can I please have a coffee and an avec, and my friend would like something a bit more refreshing.
Sure. Would you like me to prepare something for you in the bar right here, or would you like some recommendations? Certainly. Super. Excellent. So, well, I'm not quite sure which one of you to start with. I guess we could commence with the coffee, as it takes a little bit of time to brew. And we have a beautiful Nespresso machine here with a single origin range of coffee. This one is also organic, so it's a quite new enterprise for Nespresso. Of course, they have a little bit of, I guess, divided opinions in the market, but the coffee itself is of very high quality, and of course they also try to emphasize that the brand is about sustainability and good coffee, as all the leftovers are recycled, both the aluminum and of course the coffee itself is used for compost, so it's actually a lot better than some people might think, and the coffee itself really just tastes amazing. So we'll just preheat the cup for you, sir. For the avec, I have a beautiful Diplomatico rum. Would that suit you, sir? Excellent. Do you like a rum in the rocks glass, or should I find you perhaps a smaller wine glass? So, luckily, we have everything available here, so just a small wine glass to help bring all the beautiful aromas together, of course, unless you prefer it on ice. Excellent. So a regular Norwegian four measurer. This is your spirit, sir. Just borrow this glass. Of course, with coffee, it's all about temperature as well, so it's super beneficial to have a pre-warm cup. Would you prefer an espresso or a slightly larger coffee, sir? Excellent. All right, and for you? Well, we have a beautiful selection of Fevertree tonic waters, which is one of the most signature and well-known tonic producers, started in 2004, so they've been doing it for quite some time, and sourced their quinine from quite a few conflicted countries, unfortunately, but also very high quality. So I guess we'll make something, any particular style you like? Are you into kind of the more bitter or into more classic gin tonic? A bit more classic, refreshing, exactly, yeah, indeed. Well, you know, bitter can also be refreshing, but I think we'll go really, really classically for you with a beautiful gin and tonic. So, just a little bit of preparations here. So I'm putting the orange in the bottom of the glass to help flavor throughout the drink. And we'll also add a little bit of rosemary, which is quite, well, not unusual, but really brings forward a different style to the gin, and at least not the tonic, and really focuses on this herbal character, what we have. So I'm using the different side of the measuring cup now to make sure it's no traces of rum for you. And it's a beautiful Spanish gin, Gin Mare, one of my personal favorites, and is quite often actually served with rosemary because it picks up this herby character in the gin itself. On a very own bottle, sir, custom made. So that's for you, super. Amount of ice, of course, to keep it cold. And then for your tonic, we're going to go with the Mediterranean tonic here, which is, again, slightly more herbaceous than your regular tonic, and really gives you this fresh floral taste that we want. There we go, don't have to watch the empty bottle. And as you're quite the handsome chap, a little flower wouldn't hurt. Let's do two, because it's Saturday. No, actually Sunday. See, there we go. Look at that, beautiful. Let me just do a quick flourish for you. There we go. Please enjoy. Anything else I can do for you? And your coffee. There we go. Would there be anything else for you guys, or are you good for now? Super good, excellent, thank you. Enjoy. Are you doing still a sparkling water, madam?
Sparkling, please.
Super. And how was the Musar with your duck? Very good to hear, sorry.
Fredrik?
How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Super, excellent.
How are you?
Tremendous.
You're finished.
Really?
Yeah, you are.
Can I do something more?
Of course.
You want a drink as well?
That would be nice, but I have to wait. I'm on work, you know.
Okay.
So, but well, thank you.
Thank you very much. Enjoy
big
your evening.
Big hand for Henrik. For those of you who doesn't know it, Henrik has been doing this before. Henrik is not just been winning the Norwegian Championships one time, but he has also been winning it four times. And I think that is as many times as the man sitting over here, Robert.
Robert has it.
He has it. So you're aiming for the fifth time today?
Maybe. We'll see.
You cross our fingers?
Future holes, of course. Not gonna happen. Well, as he's judging, you know, it's...
That's true. Okay. Thank you, Henrik. A big
thank
applause for Henrik.
Thank you.
So, we'll have a small break again while we change for the third competitors. So, everyone can take the glasses and get some more wine. Okay, welcome back. Velkommen tilbake. Før tredje finalist skal på scenen, skal jeg også bare ta en liten ting til på norsk. Og det at vi gjennom mange år, det vil da si Norsk Vinkelforening og dette arrangementet, har samarbeidet med Oslo Vinfestival. Grunnen til det har jo vært at vi gjennom 8 år har hatt dette arrangementet på Latter på Aker Brygge, og samme helgen så har jo Oslo Vinfestival blitt arrangert på samme sted. Så vi har samarbeidet. Nå har vi flyttet sted. Vi her. Oslo Vinfestival arrangeres ikke før neste helg, men allikevel så samarbeider vi, for det synes jo vi hyggelig å holde på gode samarbeid. Så jeg vil egentlig bare minne dere alle på at neste helg på Aker Brygge så arrangeres Oslo Vinfestival. Det er en flott festival, masse spennende arrangementer og mye gode viner å smake på. Så det er absolutt verdt et besøk. Så har vi 3D. Da ønsker vi velkommen. Our next finalist, number 3, are entering the stage. Welcome, candidate number 3.
Yes, this is me.
Good to know. This this is your restaurant for the evening.
All right.
You have 21 minutes to fulfill the task given to you by these guests. You will start here and then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task. Do you want me to repeat?
Yes? Absolutely. That would be very nice.
This is your restaurant for the evening. You have 21 minutes to fulfill the task given to you by these guests. You will start here and then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task. Okay, you can start.
Excellent. Then I may start. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you doing this evening? Good.
We have already enjoyed our aperitif and are now ready to start our 4-course meal.
Thank you.
We have only ordered the wine for the main course, a half bottle of Chateau Musard 2001.
All right.
Which we would like you to decant for us. Please recommend wines to the remaining 3 dishes.
Can you please repeat the task?
We have already enjoyed our aperitif and are now ready to start our 4-course meal. We have only ordered the wine for the main course, a half bottle of Chateau Musard 2001, which we would like you to decant for us.
Of course.
Please recommend wines for the remaining 3 dishes.
Yes, please. Then I may start. I leave you the menu here. And then we'll see what I can do for you. So, let me start you off with the Chateau Musard from Bekaa Valley in Lebanon. 2001 vintage, quite mature now. And I will decant this for you. The cork is in excellent condition, considering that 2001 actually is some years ago. Oh, smells great, really developed. Mm, great stuff. So just rinse the decanter, just to make sure. Do you mind me tasting? Thank you.
So, what can you tell us about Canard à la presse, or main course?
So, Canard à la presse, it's a classical French dish where you often serve the whole duck, of course, with the confit of the leg and the breasts, and the rest of the duck, to put it like that. They put it inside a press, press out the juice, to make a sauce out of it. So it's quite intense, but it's a classical French dish. There is one restaurant, I believe, doing it in Oslo. So it is absolutely possible. Please, sir, if you don't mind. Thank you. This Chateau Musard 2001 will actually be beautiful together with the Canard à la presse, since it has some development. It shows great fruit and bodies, and the tannins are quite mature and delicate. So this would actually be my choice for your main course as well. But however, to start with your consommé du Morel, which is a clear consommé made on morels, of course, I will take you to the southern part of Spain and serve you Oloroso sherry from Lestao. This is really beautiful, together with the nutty flavors, the mushroomy flavors, the great acidity. This will freshen up your palate and really make you ready. Then the confit à la presse. We continue with the Chateau Musard, of course. And then, since it has the fruit and the body and the texture, it's really nice. And the crepes Suzette, I think it's great to finish off the crepes Suzette with a classical Tokaj from Hungary, vintage 1999. I will serve you the first vintage of Kapi made by Disnoko, which is a beautiful wine at the moment, showing really delicate aromas and development here. Excellent. Would you like to keep the cork, sir? Thank you. Is there anything else I could do for you? No, then please enjoy your menu and I'll be right back to pour you some more. Sorry, I'll be right back to pour you some more wine when you are a little bit into the meal. So please enjoy. Thank you. Good evening, sir. How may I help you?
Yes, we've been studying your wine list, but there seems to be a few errors.
Have some.
Could you please correct it for us?
Yes, I will do my absolute best here. All right. Let's go for sparkling wines. Knightimber Blanc de Blanc, vintage 2012, Sussex, England. This is correct. Arras Grand Vin, 2007, Marlborough, Australia. In my mind, Marlborough is in New Zealand, not in Australia, unfortunately. I'm sure they could do a great job there as well, but the region is Marlborough from New Zealand. Paul Rocher, Sir Winston Churchill, 1975, from Champagne in France. I actually think this is a vintage, the 75. I think this is the only vintage made by Paul Rocher, Sir Winston Churchill, only in Magnums. But I can think that the smaller version was in 83, but I believe this is to be correct, but only in Magnums then. White wines, Prager, Kellerberg, Grüner, Veltliner, Smaragd, 13 from Kamptal, Austria. This is, Kamptal is incorrect. They're located in Wachau. Prager is, however, a very nice producer. It's a good recommendation for you. You look thirsty, sir. Then to continue with Jean-Marc Hulot, Chardonnay, Chakra. Why the hell is this standing there? 2018, Patagonia, Argentina. This can explain it. then I believe this wine is to be correct. Then the red wines, Domaine Rollot, Chambol Musigny, Premier Cru, Claude Labussier, 2010, from Burgundy, France. Actually, sir, I've changed my mind. You should have this wine. This is excellent at the moment. Beautiful. This wine is correct. Avaro Palacio El Eremita, 1992, Priorat, Spain. This is also correct. Large formats, Michel Chapaudier, De Laurier Blanc, Hermitage Magnum, 2014, Rhône, France. This is correct. Chateau Montelena, Cabernet Sauvignon, Magnum, 94, Sonoma Coast, California, USA. This is incorrect. Chateau Montelena is not in Sonoma, it's in Napa Valley. Natural wines, my favorite. Domaine Allier and Oliver de Moreau-Saint-Brie, 2015, Burgundy, France, is correct. Weingut Maria Unsepp Murera, yeah, this is a bit difficult for me to explain, I'm sorry. From 2013, Südsteiermark, Austria, I believe this is correct. Emilio Peppe, Montepulciano di Abruzzo, 2001, Abruzzo, Italy, I believe also this is correct. Sweet wines, Maximin Grünhaus, Absberg Riesling, Bernhardslese, 2018, Riesling, Rheinhessen, France. Maximin Grünhaus, first of all, doesn't make wine in Rheinhessen, he makes wine in Mosel, but I also don't believe that he didn't make any Bernhardslese in the vintage 2018, but he's located in Germany. Chateau de Chem, Imperial, 1984, Barchac, Bordeaux, France. I believe this is Sauterne, but yes, they are located in Barjac, but the classification of the wine list should be Sauterne. Royal Tokai, Asu Essentia, 2011, from Tokai Heia. Yeah, that's not correct, it's from Tokai in Hungary. So I hope I answered your questions. Sir, is there anything else I can do for you?
No.
Then I go and get you the Rumier then. Excellent. Hello, sir.
Then we would like some after-dinner drinks.
Lüfter.
I would like a coffee and an avec, and
yes.
My friend would like something a bit more fresher.
All right. A bit more fresher. You mean like a cocktail, perhaps? Or yeah, okay. I will serve you my Nicaraguan coffee, up-brew in V60. It's really fresh and elegant then. It's Arabica beans. And then on the side, I can look, you have a small beard, I can see. So a whiskey would be very nice for you. And then I would go to Japan and serve you the Yoichi, which is a single malt from Yoichi in Japan. Does that sound good for you, sir? Yes. And for you, sir, I will serve you one of my favorite cocktails. It's a pre-dinner cocktail, but it's a Manhattan. So it's really fresh and nice. You also have beards, but it's a little bit masculine. It's made with the Campari, some Canadian bourbon, and some vermouth. And it packs a punch, but it's really nice and lingering, I would say. So hope that will do good for you, gentlemen. Excellent. So is there anything else I can do for you? Would you like the cigar? You look like a cigar.
Yes, I love cigars.
But yes, no. But not today.
No,
but then we skip it today.
You're finished.
I'm done.
You're done.
All right.
How does it feel? Okay.
A lot better now, I would say. Yeah.
Not nervous anymore. It's okay.
Yeah, it was great to be here, to be honest with you.
Good. Then you can go down, just take your seat, and enjoy the next competitor on the
stage. Thank you.
Okay, før alle tar pause, before everyone is leaving this room, we will have our sponsor up on the stage. We have Enrico Gobino from Cuvage joining us here. We are very happy to have you, Enrico. Okay, thank you. As I told all of you earlier today, they have had a blind tasting outside. So he will now tell us the results.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks for having me here. It's a pleasure and an honor, and I've learned so many things tonight. I'm going to use them all next time I'm at the restaurant. So some of you have tasted some of our wines. Just a few words. My name is Enrico Gobino. I'm from Italy, from Piemonte, where our winery is also from. You have tasted some of our wines. The winery name is called Cuvage, and we're based in the Monferrato area, close to Acqui Terme. So tonight we have tasted some bubbles. Our winery produces Metodo Classico, traditional method. Some of you know that Piemonte is really the cradle of sparkling wines, of a traditional method in Italy. And tonight you have tasted some Nebbiolo Rosé, so Nebbiolo d'Alba, 24 months surly, and traditional method, and it's slightly, it's a pale rosé. But the blind tasting, should I first call the one who won the blind tasting, of course, and I would like to invite Mr. Andreas Högfeldt, if I pronounce it correctly. Because it was already complicated to see the Nebbiolos, but Andreas, congratulations. This is our Cuvage des Artistes, and it's a Pinot Noir Chardonnay. And you didn't add it, but you were the one that went close to it. But there's a little bit of Nebbiolo as well, vinified in white. So this is actually a small limited edition that we have for our Cuvage des Artistes. It's a project that we also started as a fundraising, using also art for fundraising for health causes, mainly for young kids. And it's a small production that we've dedicated. And it's the same assemblage, the same blend, which also covers, through which we do our Altalanga DOCG. So along with our Nebbiolo d'Alba DOC, the Rosé, we also have the Altalanga, which we haven't showed yet, but this is the same blend, and it's a limited edition from 2013 vintage. Congratulations, Andreas, again. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And congratulations. See you later.
Thank you. Bye-bye. It's a pleasure to having you here. Then we can have a short break before the fourth and last finalists. Thank you. Okay, welcome back. Get everyone in here because we are ready for candidate number four.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome, candidate number four.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Thank you. This is your restaurant for the evening.
It's a beautiful
You have
restaurant.
21 minutes to fulfill the task given to you by these guests.
Perfect.
You will start here.
Thank you.
And then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task.
Perfect.
Do you want me to repeat?
Yes, please.
This is your restaurant for the evening. You have 21 minutes to fulfill the task given to you by these guests. You will start here and then move over to the small table where you will be given your next task.
Thank you.
Okay. You may start.
Thank you. Good evening. How can I help you tonight?
We have already enjoyed our aperitif and are now ready to start our four-course meal.
Thank you, sir.
We have only ordered the wine for the main course, a half bottle of Chateau Musard 2001, which we would like you to decant for us.
Thank you.
Please recommend wines to the remaining three dishes.
Perfect. Thank you very much. So, I will just have a look in the cellar, what I can find for you for the menus. You already chose a beautiful wine for the main course, so I will find a wine for the other courses. Thank you. Yes, I'm back to you. So, since you already enjoy your aperitif, I actually would like you to try some more bubble for the Fin de Clare. I would like actually to go to Tasmania, House of Arras, which is a Grand Vintage 2007. It's a blend of Chardonnay and Pinot Noir, traditional method, mainly from Tamar Valley and Piper River region. It stays over 7 years on lease. So it will be a perfect combination with this richness and complexity and acidity with the shellfish, with the Fin de Clare. Continuing to the Consommé de Morelle, it's a lovely umami dish. It's quite light and delicate. So I would like to serve you a wine that is as light and as delicate, and as well a bit with the umami and complexity. So I would like to go to Burgundy. I would like to serve you the Domaine Roumier Claude de la Boussière Premier Cru from Moret Saint-Denis from the vintage 2004. It was a slightly colder vintage, so you get a lot of this lovely mushroomy umami flavors that will match the Morello, which are as well in that style. And then, again, you choose the beautiful Chateau Mussard for the Canard à la Presse, so we skip over that and we go to the Crêpe Suzette. For that one, I would like to suggest you a single vineyard, Six Potonios Tokai from Dishnoko. The vineyard is Capi, which is very close to Zavas Mali, which is one of the best two vineyards in Tokai. Here we have a blend of Ash Level and Fourmint grape, which is producing with Six Potonios, so it's quite sweet. It's over under, it's around 150 grams per liter of residual sugar. After that, I don't know if you are considering some coffee and maybe some avec, so I would like to serve you some coffee, some Colombian coffee from Meran Cafe, from Serra del Valle. And to that, I would like to serve you a Tobermory 12 years old single malt whiskey from the Isle of Mull in Scotland. How does it sound? Perfect. Would you like to keep the menu again? There you go, sir. And then I will come back for the Chateau Mussard. This is the one for you, sir. The 2001 Chateau Mussard. Thank you. It's a quite legendary producer you choose today. Chateau Mussard, it's one of the producers from Lebanon, from the Bekaa Valley in Lebanon. And they have been around since the 70s. And that period, actually, they survived in a way the civil war in Lebanon. They had to transport the grapes with Red Cross trucks to avoid to be bombed during the civil war in the 80s. Should I serve as well the wine, or should I just decant it for you? Should I serve as well the wine, or should I just decant it for you? Serve it as well. Thank you, sir. It's good to let it breathe a bit in the glass while you're waiting for the main course. So it's a quite tall bottle with a quite tall cork, and usually when you have also small bottles, the cork get a bit more old faster. So it's good to use this type of opener. It's called Durand. It's quite safe opener to use for the old corks, because as you can see, you have two part of it. You have first the spiral that goes in, and then you put the two blades beside, and the spiral keep it up. And the cork is in excellent condition, by the way. May I taste your wine? Thank you, sir. I will not take too much of yours, since it's a half bottle. So I'm just rinsing the decanter to avoid that any impurity will come in your glass eventually. Quite confident that I washed them correctly, but just to be sure. Perfect.
What can you tell us about canard à la presse, our main course?
Canard à la presse, that's a very famous French dish. Canard, of course, is the duck. So it's the old duck put in a special press. Or you basically have the juice of the... I will stop here because you have some decant, some sediment. So you basically have the duck, which is put in this special press and is cooked in a way. And then you have the juice that is squeezed out from all the remaining after to take off the breast. The cork for you for inspection. And if you want to taste the wine for me, please. So since you are enjoying two courses before that, I just pour a bit in the glass so you can start to enjoy it. And then I will leave the rest in the decanter, and I will come back later to pour it on a bit more, maybe, or maybe not. We'll see. There you go. Would you like to keep the cork? Thank you. Do you drink still or sparkling water tonight, madam?
Sparkling, please.
Perfect. And for you, madam, still or sparkling?
Still.
Perfect. You're welcome, madam. For you, madam, still or sparkling? Sparkling. And sir, for you, still sparkling. Perfect. May I help you with something else?
No.
Perfect. Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening.
How may I help you tonight?
Yes. We have been studying your wine list, but there seems to be a few errors.
Oh, sorry
about
that.
Please help us to correct those.
Of course. May I take it with me?
Certainly.
Thank you very much, sir. Sorry, madam. It looks like that I didn't do a good job by cleaning my glass today. Beautiful. Beautiful twice, I would say. Yes, so here I am to you. I do find some mistake in my list. I'm sorry about that. First of all, the House of Arras, as we correct, or Arras Grand Vintage 2007, which actually they're enjoying with their starter here, is not from Marlborough, but it's from Tasmania. So it's still in Australia. Marlborough is in New Zealand, of course. So that was a mistake. Sorry about that. Then when it comes to the white, the Prager Kelleberg Grüne Veltliner Smaragd 2013. Prager is a beautiful producer from Wachau, not from Kremsal. Chakra, Jean-Marc Roulot Chardonnay 2018 from Patagonia in Argentina. Here, unfortunately, Jean-Marc Roulot shouldn't be there, even though it's a very beautiful producer for Chardonnay. He's not from Patagonia in Argentina. Moving on to Domaine Roumière, again, they are enjoying it with their second course, the Claude Laboussière from Moret-Saint-Denis, not from Chambol-Moussigny. So that's the mistake there, unfortunately. And then when it comes to the large format, Chateau Montelena Cabernet Sauvignon Magnum, beautiful producer, Chateau Montelena. It's not from Sonoma Coast in California, but it's from Napa Valley. Continuing to the natural wine, Alice and Olivero de Moore Saint Brie. They do not produce Saint Brie, as far as I know. So that's the mistake. They produce Chablis. Weingut Maria and Sepp Munster, Grafi Marior Grosse Esteco Lage, is from Südsteiermark. So we're missing a T in the Steiermark. And then continuing to the sweet wines, Maximin Grunau's Absberger Blanc Schlese 2018 is not released yet, unfortunately. While the Chateau de Cam Imperial, it is from Bordeaux, but not from Barsac, but from Sauternes, of course. So sorry very much for the mistakes.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Can I do something else for you? Thank you. Are you drinking sparkling water, madam? Perfect.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
We would like to have some after-dinner drinks.
Excuse me, Indian.
We would like to have some after-dinner drinks.
Perfect.
Can I please have a coffee and an avec? And my friend would like something a bit more refreshing.
Perfect. I will do it. Thank you. Sorry, I'll just come here around. Nice and cozy. All right. So, how do you like Peru Organic from Nespresso for your coffee? Using this lovely Nespresso machine, but I think I have to take it on before that I serve the espresso for you. So while it warms up, I'm gonna find a nice avec. So what about some room with your coffee? Could it be nice? A Diplomático, maybe? Perfect. From Venezuela, of course. Would you like it straight or on the ice? Perfect. There you go, sir. Room Diplomático. And then I will fix a coffee straight away. Would you like it short, medium, or long? Medium, perfect. And for you, sir, something refreshing? Let me see what I get. Oh, I think I have to taste this one to know what I get. Syrup. You know, just to be sure. It's always a good thing to be sure. All right. So I'm thinking I'm going quite simple. I will do a Jim Fitz. Oh, actually, I will do a Tom Collins, so we just do a build-up, if it's fine for you. So here we have some beautiful gin. And some lemon juice, some tonic water. I would like to use maybe the Mediterranean from Fever Tree, which is quite nice and fresh, and it's not as bitter as the other one. And I will do it twist to that, because I would like to garnish it with some orange instead of lemon. But of course, you will have the lemon juice in it. Thank you. Sounds good?
Perfect.
Perfect. Here is your coffee, sir. Thank you. Actually, since I just served the room and I want to have a room tasting your cocktail as well. So I'm going to just raise a bit the measuring. So 4 centimeters of beef eater. And then we go with 4 centiliters of lemon juice. Touch of syrup. And as I told you, a beautiful Mediterranean fever tree. How was your coffee, sir? Perfect. Beautiful to hear that. That's better. We can actually just do it like that. There you go, sir. Would you like some water? Some water for you, sir? Perfect. I'll be back to you. A bit more wine, madam? Perfect. Should it deserve a bit more wine as well? All right, then I guess we will complete it for the ladies. If it's fine for you, sir. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Welcome. Anything else I can do for you? Everything is good? How is your cocktail? Thank you, sir. Hope so. Well, I think I will serve you water anyway. It's a very quiet evening in the restaurant tonight. So do you prefer still or sparkling?
Sparkling.
Perfect. Oops, sorry. So we have this beautiful Norwegian water for you. It's called Voss water. And even though the name is Voss, it's not from the beautiful town of Voss. Sorry. It is from the East Agder region here in Norway. But actually, the name Voss, it's an old Narana name, which means water. So that's why the name Voss, for the water. I guess it's time. Thank you. Hi.
Hi. You're finished?
I guess so.
Yeah? Good? Does it feel well?
Yeah. It's nice.
Yeah. You have done this before, haven't you?
Sometimes.
Yeah. And also, I think you won the Nordic Championship in 2018, didn't you?
I did. Yes.
The Nordic Champion 2018.
Thank you.
Now you can go down, relax for a little while. Mm-hmm. Because now it is bubbles and burger time.
So
if everyone's hungry, you can go out to the right. There is bubbles and burgers from Bella Vista. But please come back quickly because the competition is not quite finished. So in 5 to 10 minutes, the competition starts again.
May I get some water?
Do you go for one? Okay. Okay, everyone, welcome back. We have now reached the end of the individual tasks, but we are not yet ready with the competition. So I would like to ask all the 4 finalists back up on stage. And if I may have 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Yes, ma'am.
And you may stand here. In front of them. Thank you. So, guys, for this task, you have 10 seconds per slide to answer the questions on the slides. Please write your answers on the whiteboard and show it to the jury who's sitting down there. Okay? Do you want me to repeat? Yes. For this task, you have 10 seconds per slide to answer the questions on the slides. Please write your answer on the whiteboard and show it to the jury. Okay. You may start. And the answer was? And that was the last slide. Good job. So you may turn around, face the audience. Now, I think you recognize this. This is a classic sparkling service. You are only allowed to pour once per glass, no going back. and you have to finish the bottle. The amount of wine should be equal in all glasses. You have 5 minutes. You want me to repeat? This is a classic sparkling service. You are only allowed to pour once per glass, no going back, and you have to finish the bottle. The amount of wine should be equal in all glasses. You have 5 minutes, and you may start. Great job. So are the judges, are you going to look more? Yeah? So, finalists, this was the last task of this competition. So now you can step down from the stage, relax for a while, while we continue to talk a little bit about the competition and how what we have been going through these last 2 days. So, but then we will continue. So, we are going to talk a little bit about the competition and what we have been doing for the last 2 days. And first, we are going to talk about Junior Wine Awards. Og da kommer jeg til å gjøre det på norsk. Junior Wine Awards og NM startet i går. Ja, de deltakerne i Junior Wine Awards startet med en teoriprøve med 35 spørsmål. Siden måtte de ha en skriftlig blindsmaking av 2 viner, og de hadde 20 minutter på blindsmakingen og 35 minutter på teoriprøven. Etter det hadde de en ost- og vinanbefaling, og de hadde en hvitvinsservice foran dommere. Manuel klikker. Det fint. Så har jo de vært på finalen, og de som da ikke var her og så finalen tidligere i dag, så kan vi informere om at de begynte med å blindsmake 3 viner, hvor de også skulle finne da en fellesnevner. De hadde en klassisk rødvinsdekantering, og de måtte sette vin til en meny. Vinene de hadde på blindsmakingen under teoriprøven var Matua Lands & Legends Marlboro Sauvignon Blanc 2018 og Le Meunier's Cross Hermitage 2018. Vinene de hadde her på scenen som de smakte blindt var Dr. Lucen Blue Slate Riesling 2018, André Ostertag Riesling 2018 og Som Young Punk's Monsters Monsters Attack 2019. Når vi da kommer over til NM, I'll take this in English. They had a theory tests of 60 questions, a written blind tasting, they had a sparkling service, and they had a white wine service. The wines they were tasting in the blind tasting was Bargelius Grand Vin de Syrie, Judean Hills 2017, Chateau Musard Blanc. Also, they had Egge Liersider and Balholm Sognefjord. And they should find out that there was one with food apples and one with cider apples. The semifinal, they had to blind taste spirits. They had a sake service and to put sake to a menu. They had to identify 4 blue cheeses and recommend wines to each cheese. Then they also had a blind tasting where they had black glasses, and that makes it even harder to identify the wine because you cannot see the color of the spirit in the glass. They had ouzo, pastis, and arak. And also they had un-oaked spirits, Armagnac Blanche, Grappa, and Pisco. Then, on the final, they had a red wine decanting and serving to 4 guests. They had to recommend wines to menu. They had to correct our wine lists and serve after-dinner drinks to guests in the bar. Then, of course, they had a quiz, and they had to serve sparkling wine, as you can see. Next. So, the wine lists. And I would like to tell you, and I will do this in Norwegian, at vi har hatt en veldig spesiell hjelper med oss på denne konkurransen. For dere som har fulgt med på konkurransen gjennom flere år, så har dere kanskje sett at det en deltaker som ikke har vært på scenen i år, men som har vært med ikke bare 3 ganger, ikke 5 ganger, men hele 10 ganger tidligere i NM. Og det Simon Zimmermann. Simon har vært så grei at han har hjulpet oss nå under denne konkurransen. Vært en flittig medhjelper. Og han skal nå da gjøre oss den æren at han skal rette vinkartet for oss. Da burde jo vi hatt en mikrofon. Nå vet jeg ikke hvordan det har blitt det. Klarer du å prate høyt? Ligger den oppe, eller skal den hete?
Alle hører meg.
Ja. Stå helt nærme meg. Eller har vi en mikrofon der borte? Vi har en mikrofon. Liora har kontroll. Det flott. Så, so, ta det på engelsk. And the list is coming.
So, do you like the wine list? Yeah, perfect. So, there was lots of fault in this wine list, as you can see. Nightingale did not make 2012 because it was a horrible vintage, so it was not produced.
The Arras is from Tasmania, not Marlborough, in Australia. And of course, 1971 of Sir Winston Churchill was only bottled in Magnum, so it should be under large formats. Prager does not make Kellerberg because it's in the village of Dürnstein. Prager is located in the village of Weisenkirchen, so Achleiten, Wachstum, Bodenstein could be the right vineyard. And of course, it's located in Wachau in Austria. As you can see, Schumacher Rouleau in 2018 did a wine together with the winemaking team at Bodega Chacra in Patagonia in Argentina in 2018. Many of you got tricked by a Burgundy producer, but many of them are doing joint venture at the moment. And then, of course, some classical Chambolle Musigny and Claude Laboussière is not is only in Maurice Saint-Denis. And of course, first vintage of El Ermita is 93. And Chapoutier, as you can see, the Magnum Hermitage Blanc is, of course, bottled. And many of you got the Sonoma Coast for the Napa Valley on the Chateau Montelena, very prestigious estate. And of course, some tricky questions here as well. So the Esteco Große Lage is only for white wines. This wine is orange wine, so it's not allowed to be Große Lage. And it's even bottled as Steirerland in Landwein, so it's a declassified wine. And it's not located in Südsteiermark, it's located in Weststeiermark, together with other natural guys and in that region. And then and Maximin Grünhaus is, of course, in Mosel Valley. We have, of course, Chateau de Chem in Sauternes. But the Imperial, if someone noted, Imperial is 6 liters, so it should also be on the large format. And then Asu Essentia was not made after 2009. So after that vintage, it was 6 Pitones in that vintage from Royal Tokai. So a small fun task for you guys. So thank you.
Oh, thank you, Simon. So, Junior Wine Award. Vi skal gå gjennom det veldig snart, og vi skal gå gjennom premiene. Men aller først så skal våre 4 finalister fra NM få lov til å gjøre en siste oppgave for oss. Hello, there you are. So our 4 finalists from the championship are going to do one more task for us, and that is to take these glasses of sparkling wine and to take them out to the audience. But one important thing to the audience. Because while the judges are collaborating and finding our winner, we have to stay put and wait. It will not take many minutes. So please stay inside here with these glasses. Enjoy the bubbles there, talk amongst yourselves, have some fun. And afterwards, when we are finished with everything, we have announced the winners, you can deliver this glass outside to us, outside the door. Okay? So here it comes, the bubbles. Ja, da nærmer vi oss jo den store finalen. Nå skal vi aller først kåre vinneren i Junior Wine Award. Og da vil jeg be alle finalistene i Junior Wine Award om å komme opp på scenen. Gi dem en applaus! Kandidatene i årets Junior Wine Award, for dere som ikke var her tidligere i dag, er da Isabella Zapala, Jens Nordnes, Mats Alexander Petteru Henriksen, Michael Fabrizio Alata Mamami, Nikolai Haram Svarte og Ole Edvard Berg. En stor applaus! Da vil jeg be om at bare finalistene står igjen. Og de skal få et diplom. President Liora Levi skal dele ut diplom til de som ikke kom videre til finalen. Ja, kjære finalister. Det første vi skal gjøre er å gå
og ta en liten gjennomgang og se på de flotte premiene som venter våre finalister. For våre gode partnere har jo vært så greie og kommet med premier til alle finalistene, både i Junior Wine Award og i Norsk Vinkjellermesterskap. Og førsteplassen, nå må dere bare fære med meg her, for jeg har en lang liste med premier. Førsteplassen i Junior Wine Award får en Magnum Dr. Birkeland Wolf Geispel Edition GC Riesling 2016, Lamy Centenet Rouge Lehets, Delamain Grand Champagne Pale and Dry, Georg Jensen Damask Duc Volnay Le Creuset Vinåpner, Tenuta Caretta Barbera di Alba Magnum, Sandi Santa Rita Hills Chardonnay, og det er veldig morsomt, den er faktisk signert, for Rajat Par var her i dag og har signert flasken. Dr. Lusen Urtziger Wirtsgarten Riesling GG 2017, Catena Alta Cabernet Sauvignon 2018, Riedel Kraffel Flamingo med JVA-logo på, 6 flasker Mathieu Lance & Legends Marbleau Sauvignon Blanc, 6 flasker Mathieu Lance & Legends Marbleau Pinot Noir, Dom Perignon 2008, Bella Vista Cuvée Alma, Riedel 2 stykk topakk med varglass, Nespresso kaffemaskin, gavekort fra Thon Hotels på en helg, og gavekort fra Ludo til 2 personer. Det var førsteplassen. Stor applaus! Så, andreplassen. Wagner Stempel Herkrets Riesling GG 2018, Gigal Cote Roti Brunet Blond 2016, Le Creuset Vinåpner, Tenuta Caretta Barbera di Alba Magnum, igjen Sandi Santa Rita Hills Chardonnay, signert, Dr. Lusen Urtziger Wirtsgarten Riesling GG 2017, Catena Alta Cabernet Sauvignon 2018, Riedel Caraffel Coronetto Magnum, 6 flasker Mathieu Lance & Legends Marbleau Sauvignon Blanc, 6 flasker Mathieu Lance & Legends Marbleau Pinot Noir, Moët de Chandon Magnum 2009, Bella Vista Cuvée Alma, Riedel 2 stykk topakk med barglass og Nespresso kaffemaskin. Så, dere skal ikke gå tomhent hjem, gutter. Ingen av dere. Håper dere har stor bagasje med plass på plyet. Tredjeplass, Chateau Hot Special Gloria 2016, Le Creuset Vinåpner, Tenuta Caretta Barbera di Alba Magnum, Sandy Santa Rita Hills Chardonnay, Dr. Lusen Urtziger Wurzegarten Riesling GG 2017, Catena Alta Cabernet Sauvignon 2018, Riedel Caraffel Coronetto, 6 flasker Mathieu Lance & Legends Marlboro Sauvignon Blanc, 6 flasker Mathieu Lance & Legends Marlboro Pinot Noir, Moët Chandon Magnum 2009, Bella Vista Cuvée Alma, Riedel 2x2-pakk varglass og en espresso kaffemaskin. Ja, da til det vi selvfølgelig lurer på. Vi kommer først til å kåre tredjeplassen. Og tredjeplassen i dette årets Juno Wine Awards, som er arrangert i samarbeid med Matua, er Jens Nordnes! Så, for å gjøre det veldig spennende, så tar vi da nå førsteplassen. Vi skal da ikke glemme andreplassen, men vi tar nå først førsteplassen. Og vinneren i årets Junior Wine Award 2020 i samarbeid med Matua, det er Nikolai Haram Svarte! Det vil jo da si at andreplassen gikk til Ole Edvard Berg. Stor applaus! Ja, gratulerer så mye. Har vi en Liora? Har vi en sponsor som skal ta bildet? Eller skal vi ta det etterpå etter henne? Hold dere i nærheten, gutta, og så blir det mer bilder etterpå. Tusen takk. Stor applaus! Da har vi kommet til å kåre vinneren av The Norwegian Championship 2020 i samarbeid med Kuvage. Da vil jeg be de 4 finalistene komme opp på scenen.
The four candidates may please enter the stage. Sorry.
Skal jeg ta fjerdeplassen? Kan han gå ned før vi tar alle premiene? Vi tar fjerdeplassen nå. Ta fjerdeplassen nå før alle premiene, så han kan gå ned igjen.
A little hugging. Oh, come on. Okay, guys. Four finalists. And the rules are like this, that we have competitors from other countries, but they cannot win this competition. Neither can they come on the second or third place, but they have participated, and we are very happy to have had you here. And then Leora have a small gift for you as well. Thank you so much. Maximilian Will. So as he is entering down from the stage, we will have a look at the prizes for our finalists. And I will do this as best I can in Norwegian. So, førsteplass, I NM, Charles Heidsieck, Magnum, Biondi Santi, Rosso 15, Dunhoff GG, Delsen 2017, Santi Sankta Rita Hills Chardonnay, igjen selvfølgelig signert, Dr. Lusen, Urtsyge, Wurstegarten, Riesling GG 2017, Catena Alta Cabernet Sauvignon 2018, Dom Perignon 2008, en tur til Cuvage, det må nevnes ekstra høyt, Cuvage Magnum, Bella Vista Cuvée Alma, Riedel Karaffel Flirt, Nespresso Kaffemaskin, gavekort fra Thon Hotel på en helg, gavekort fra Crew for to personer, Lusto East India, Magnum Brunello di Montalcino 2012, fra Poggio Antico, Magnum, Dr. Birklin, Wolf, Geisbøl, Edition, GC Riesling 2016, Delamain, Grand Champagne, Pale & Dry, en Georg Jensen Damask Duke Volnay, og en Le Creuset vinåpner. Andreplass, Wagner Stempel, Herkreitz, Riesling, GG 2018, Gygal, Cotroti, Brunet Blond 2016, Lusto, Oloroso, Pata di Gallina, Le Creuset vinåpner. Det er ikke plass til alle premiene på ett ark engang, vet du. Så greie partnere. Charles Heidsieck Brut, Biondi Santi Rosso 15, Dunhoff GG Delsen 2017, Sandi Sankta Rita Hills Chardonnay, Dr. Lusen Urtsyger Wurstgarten Riesling GG 2017, Catena Alta Cabernet Sauvignon 2018, Moët & Chandon Magnum 2009, Cuvage Magnum, Bella Vista Cuvée Alma, Riedel Karaffel Superleggio og en Nespresso kaffemaskin. Til, ja, kom med en applaus. Flotte premier. Til tredjeplassen, som selvfølgelig heller ikke skal gå tomhent hjem etter en sånn fantastisk innsats på scenen, så har vi Chaux Haute Bergevel Gloria 2016, Lusto Fino del Puerto Almansenista González Obregón, beklager min spansk, Le Creuset vinåpner, Charles Heidsieck Brut, Biondi Santi Rosso 15, Dunhoff GG Delsen, Sandi Sankta Rita Hills Chardonnay, Dr. Lusen Urtsyger, Wurstgarten Riesling GG 2017, Catena Alta Cabernet Sauvignon 2018, Moët & Chandon Magnum 2009, Cuvage Magnum, Bella Vista Cuvée Alma, og en Riedel Karaffel Black Tie Smile. Så da, gutta, fram på scenen. Jeg vil også bruke anledningen til å takke våre fantastiske partnere. I would like to thank all our partners, because without whom we will not have this competition, or we will not have this association at all. So thank you so much to all our partners and of course the sponsor of these two events. A big hand. I would also give a great thanks to Hegnar Media, who is live streaming this event. So if you want to see it again, you can go on our social media, Facebook, Norsk Vinkjellerforening, and you can find a link and you can see all of that's happening here today again. And it's been broadcasting to all of the world. If you're not yet following us on social media, here's what you have to do. At Norsk Vinkjellerforening, Instagram and Facebook. We can also, if you're not a member yet, but you are a sommelier, of course you can be a member if you go into vinkjellner.no. We want all the sommeliers in Norway members. We would also like to thank all our great judges for having done such a good job today. We would like to thank all the board of the Sommelier Association who has been working, running around, carrying and doing all of this possible. And of course, a big hand for all who has been volunteering to help us today. So thank you, everyone. And of course, a big, big hand for Team Scandic, who is hosting us today. So, we are, as we did on JVA, we are starting with the third place. And the third place of this year's championship is Alexander Iversen. So, the big moment. Will it be the four times Norwegian champion, or will it be the Nordic champion of 2018 who is winning this year? But before you take any pictures and posting them on social media, don't forget to tag us, it's very important. We cannot say it too many times. So, the winner of this year's championship is Francesco Marsala! A big hand, come on! That, of course. Of course, that means that the second place goes to Henrik Dahl Jansen.